Hi friends, today we'll be talking about the two plots which are used basically by the enzyme kinetesis to find out and estimate the value of Km and Vmax. We know that this started, the kinetic studies, they started with the initial studies of Michaelis and Menten, which with their equilibrium approach, they tried to what you call as calculate the values of Km and Vmax and the interactions between the velocity of the reaction and the substrate concentration. This was later modified in a broader terms to be applicable to most of the enzyme, the steady state approach that is was given by our Briggs and Haldane, which modified the MM equation. This was later on modified the double reciprocal plot which we studied, that was your Lineweaver's and Burke's plot. So whether we are using which particular plot to estimate the value of Km and Vmax is actually immaterial. It is actually the data which you have, right? The amount of data and the accuracy of the data, the precision of the data, that is going to decide how accurate your values of Km and Vmax they are. So talking about this first plot, that is your Edie-Hopsey plot, it basically starts with the LB equation. So LB equation, we have 1 upon V 0 is equal to Km upon Vmax plus 1 into 1 upon S plus 1 upon Vmax. Now this simply multiply both the sides. So you multiply both the sides with V 0 into Vmax. So I'll just multiply this entire equation with V0 into Vmax. So all the terms here will be multiplied by V0 into Vmax. So I'll have V0 into Vmax, yes, into, I have this 1 upon V0 here. So this Km upon Vmax into 1 upon S, this again multiplied by V0 into Vmax. Plus, I have the last term, that is my 1 upon Vmax multiplied by V0 into Vmax. Okay, so now cancelling the common terms here, I have cancelled this V0, V0 here will get cancelled. Here I have Vmax, Vmax getting cancelled. So here I am left with, say, Vmax is equal to Km upon Vmax into Vmax, Vmax here also it will get cancelled. So I have Km into say 1 upon S into V0 and here I have plus V0, right? So now if I want to find out the value of V0, so V0 will be Vmax minus this particular value if I take here, so it is minus Km, right? Into V0 upon S. I just rearrange these terms. So I have here V0 is equal to, this I'll take first. So it is minus Km into V0 upon S plus Vmax. Yes. So now this gives me the equation of Y is equal to MX plus C, right? So this gives me the equation for plotting this Edie-Hopsey plot. So if you plot this Edie-Hopsey plot, you will find here that this Y, right, it is V0. So on Y axis, you are going to plot your value of V0. On X axis, you are going to plot the value of V0 upon S0, right? So this is a negative slope here. So the graph which you get will be something like this, right? Extrapolating this here, right? So the slope of this, no doubt. So the slope of this would be minus Km, right? And the intercept on the Y axis is your C. So here you have the value of what is called as your Vmax, right? So this gives your Edie-Hopsey plot. So if you are trying to define what you call as the axis, so Y axis is V0, X axis is V0 by S0, you have the intercept on the Y axis, that is your Vmax, and the slope, that is equal to minus Km, right? So this is the final equation for your Edie-Hopsey plot, right? And this is your graph. Talk about the Haynes plot now. So as there we multiplied it with V0 into Vmax, here we are going to multiply both the sides by S0. So let us multiply both the sides here. So multiplying both sides by S0 now. So if I am multiplying both of these sides, say I'll get S0 into I have 1 upon V0 which is equal to Km upon Vmax into 1 upon S0 multiplied by S0 plus I have 1 upon Vmax multiplied by S0. Yes, so cancelling out the terms, I think only this S0 it gets cancelled. So rearranging the terms, I get S0 upon V0 gives me Km upon Vmax plus 1 upon Vmax into S0. Now rearranging this, I have S0 upon V0 to give, right? I have 1 upon Vmax into S0 plus Km upon Vmax, right? So this gives me again the equation of Y is equal to MX plus C. So from here I have on the Y axis S0 upon V0. So here I'll plot S0 upon V0, right? So on the X axis I have S0 here, right? I have a slope of 1 upon Vmax. So this will be a straight line here. Extrapolating this now, the intercept here on this particular axis would be Km upon Vmax. And as I told, the slope, it would be 1 upon Vmax, right? So this defines the axis and we get this particular plot, that is your Haynes plot. So Haynes plot, it is S0 upon V0 is equal to 1 upon Vmax into S plus Km upon Vmax. And here you get this particular plot where you from this you can calculate the value of your Km and Vmax. So as I told, it is not important that what you are exactly using, whether you are using the Haynes plot, whether you are using the Eriofsky plot, or whether you are using the Lineweaver and Burr plot, though there are so many variations. We also have Essenthil Cornish Bowden plot, probably that we will discuss in coming videos. So it is not important which particular plot you are using. It is important that what data you are putting in these particular plots to estimate the values of your Km and Vmax. Though we have so many variations, even today many enzymologists and specifically enzyme kineticists, they prefer using Lineweaver and Burk plot. So don't get confused with these equations and graphs. Stay tuned with us for more in enzymology and microbiology. Thank you.